Hey, what's up everyone? So in this video, I'll be showing you kind of the performance that you can expect using an eGPU with a Mac Mini or really pretty much any other Mac. But basically, so the eGPU that I have specifically is the Razer Core X, and inside of it is the ASUS ROG variant of the AMD Vega 64. As far as the Mac Mini, it's pretty much fully loaded. It has the Intel Core i7-8700B, I think it is, 64 gigs of RAM, and of course, flash storage. So you know, both ends are, you know, very fast and everything, but let's put them to the test and see what we can find out. So to start off, I'll be doing some synthetic tests, and then we'll move on to playing some games and checking out the frame rates and all of the video settings for those. So as far as the synthetic tests, I'll do that both using Mac OS as well as Windows 10. But for the games, I'm just going to be using Windows 10 because, you know, Mac OS really doesn't have a great selection of games. And some of the games that I have are only available on Windows. So we're just going to test it out using the games on Windows and synthetic on both OS's. All right, so the first test that we'll do is Cinebench. I'm going to do the OpenCL test first. We'll do the CPU test later, which probably wouldn't make much of a difference with an eGPU, but the first test got done with 146.26 frames per second. For some reason, Cinebench detects this operating system as Windows 8, even though it's Windows 10. I'm not sure why, but oh well. And then test number two comes in at 139.65. And another thing which is kind of strange is that with an eGPU using Bootcamp to boot into Windows on a Mac, it doesn't fully recognize the GPU. Like, you know, it's a Vega 64 or whatever you have, but it just says RX Vega on there, which is kind of odd, but oh well. So the last test finished with around 140 frames per second for an average. And so now the CPU test is going to be coming in. Test number one is 1205, test number two is 1240. And then, as you can see right here, test number three kind of makes test number two look like an average. So this is 1270 right here. So, you know, about 1240 for an average or whatever that comes out to be. I did run the Blender test. I did just the quick test and it got a time of 5 minutes and 57 seconds. Here's the benchmark file broken out. So the BMW was 116 seconds and then the classroom was 240 seconds. So you can go ahead and compare that to, you know, whatever your system you're comparing this to, whether that's, you know, getting a actual desktop computer or, you know, a different external GPU. And so I decided to run Cinebench on macOS to see if it would make much of a difference. So, you know, it's basically the exact same setup, just different operating systems. We still have the eGPU plugged directly into the monitor. And as you can see, these test results are going to be quite a bit lower than on Windows. I'm not sure why, but either way, it is consistent. So remember, on Windows, it's about 140 frames per second. On macOS, we're getting about 115. So now we'll try the CPU test. And similar to the OpenGL test, it's a little bit lower, not so much as far as this test goes. It's a little bit lower than Windows, but I'm not sure why that is. Maybe it's just the development or whatnot. I'm not too sure. So as you can see, the tests were averaging, you know, mid to upper 1100s. So now we'll go and move on to some, you know, real world tests. So this is Fortnite, of course. I'm running at the full resolution of my monitor, which is 3840 by 1600. And we're going to be mostly on high settings, except for view distance. You know, unlimited frame rate, we'll see where it goes. And as you can see, starting out, it does look pretty good. So, you know, of course, we'll do 1080p in just a little bit, but even at, you know, this near 4K settings, we're getting in the 60s, you know, mid to upper 60s as far as frame rate, and it looks really good, especially if you have like a monitor with FreeSync or if you have an NVIDIA graphics card with G-Sync. This is going to look really good on, you know, any display. So my main goal for this game was just to try to see, you know, how much mayhem can we get in one scene. I don't get too far, as you can see in just a little bit, but the frame rate is holding steady in like the low 70s, upper 60s. Even when smashing these this floor, it's still holding steady in the 60s, and even when I get shot and killed, it's upper 60s or so, which is pretty good. Alright, so next up I wanted to try Fortnite, but tone the resolution down to 1920 by 1080, just because, you know, a lot of people use 1920 by 1080 monitors, especially high refresh monitors, just because, you know, it's hard to get a 4K high refresh rate monitor because they're just so expensive and, you know, you need a really high-end graphics card. So 1080p, a lot of people are probably going to use this. In the lobby, we're getting about 120 frames per second, which doesn't really mean a whole lot, so let's go ahead and get the game started. Alright, so as you can see so far, even though we're flying down, we were getting about 100 frames per second. And as you'll notice throughout this gameplay, if you look in the upper right corner, it stays right in the 90s to 100s. So, you know, frame rate is really good, especially with everything basically maxed out, running Fortnite at 1920 by 1080. So if you have a 1920 by 1080 monitor, this setup would be, you know, just fine. You can get a high refresh rate monitor and your games will look pretty good. So as a surprise to no one, I ended up not winning this game of Fortnite. So let's go ahead and move on to Forza. So kind of the similar thing, we're going to do, you know, a high resolution with kind of high settings instead of ultra first, and then we'll go and switch to 1920 by 1080 and try to bump up the settings and see what kind of frame rates we can get with that. So the Forza Horizon 4 actually has like a benchmarking mode built in, so it kind of gives you like an average frame rate of what you can expect if you play this game on the settings that you have chosen. So I went ahead and started the benchmark mode, and, you know, just for a little refresher, the resolution is set to 3840 by 1600. And the settings for the detail, there's no anti-aliasing, same with Fortnite. I probably should have pointed that out earlier, but no anti-aliasing. And the settings for the details are basically all on high instead of ultra. But, you know, again, we'll try ultra with 1920 by 1080. So I probably should have adjusted my camera first before recording this, but in the upper right corner it does show the frame rate, and from this game it was starting around in the 50s, and it kind of gradually worked its way up to about the mid 60s or so. So, you know, kind of same idea with Fortnite. We're going to start out, you know, in that kind of, you know, 50 to 60 range, and then once we drop the resolution down we'll see a big increase. Okay, so here we have our results, and as you can see in the bottom left corner, there's like the average frame rate. We got 60 frames per second. Our target was 75 because I put VSync on. I knew it wouldn't get to 75, but just with this monitor being at 75 hertz, I just figured I'd set that on. So driving around in the real world, we kind of have a little bit better results in terms of frame rate. So, you know, the exact same settings here, but we're getting, you know, kind of consistently 65 to 70 frames per second. Once it starts snowing or raining or something like that, you're gonna dip a little bit in frame rates. Probably when it was snowing, I was getting like 10 frames per second less than when it's like a clear day like this. So I'll get, you know, no less than 50 frames per second with this setup. Okay, so the first thing I wanted to do when changing up the settings right here is drop the frame rate down to 1920 by 1080 and keep all the other settings the same, just to see how big of an impact going from near 4K, 3840 by 1600, down to 1920 by 1080. So we're going to run that same benchmark again and see what results we get. So as you can see by the upper right corner, the frame rates are doing a lot better when it's dropped down to 1920 by 1080. And we can see by these results here, We re achieve an average of about 77 frames per second, which is really good. So this frame room clip is actually with the graphics settings on 1920 by 1080, but with the details and everything up to ultra. So you can expect in the low 70s, but once it starts snowing, like I said before, that'll drop below, probably down into the low 60s or so. But overall, pretty good. So this is with the resolution set at 1920 by 1080, but then I dropped the details and everything down to high. So the details is pretty much matching what we first had with the 3840 by 1600, all of that basically on high, no anti-aliasing, and so now we're getting about low 90s with it raining. So I've seen as high as 100, 105, maybe 110 at some points, but when it was a sunny day and not raining, not snowing, but you definitely get a performance dip using an eGPU versus just having a graphics card inside of a computer, directly attached to a motherboard. But you're still getting, good performance in a computer that's able to play games pretty well. But that's pretty much it for this video. If you have any questions, leave them down below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.